Good evening, ladies and gentlemen,
boys and girls, and welcome to Dragon Spotlight 2016! Our theme for this year is 20 years and counting, so we're looking to keep you entertained throughout the night. My name is Nathaniel Prather, and I am accompanied by the lovely Sean Hood.
Plan for you. We got singers, we got dancers, we got a film, we got teachers, we got it all. We also have the deans in the back. So if you all could behave yourselves, that'd be swell. I'm gonna try not to slip up here on the mic. They can hook you up with Saturday school if you screw up. They're not like the Breakfast Club, I can tell you that.
Well, let's not worry about Saturday yet. Let's just talk about Thursday, and let's segue into our show by introducing our marvelous panel of judges.
Alrighty, if you could raise your hand when I say your name. We have Miss Lisa Stoles for our first judge tonight. Hello. She is the RTI coordinator here at PCHS. She began her career here at PCHS 22 years ago as an English teacher. She was also the student council advisor, and she was here when Dragon Spotlight was first made. Woo! That's awesome. She loves the talent that PCHS brings, and she can't wait to see what comes tonight.
Yeah. All right. Our next judge is Mrs. Kelly Sandberg. Started her career at Pekin here in 2001, where she taught as an English teacher for 12 years, spending 9 of them as a student council advisor. For 3 years, she spent her time living in England, which I heard is very exciting. In
Buffy the Vampire Slayer, they have English accents in that.
In June of this year, she returned to reclaim her position as an English teacher here. She would like you to know that she was born in Cincinnati and loves everything about the town, from the Bengals to chili. She also made it a point to let you guys know that she has an amazing British accent. So maybe that'll be brought up later in the night. I don't know. We'll find out. So that's Mrs. Sandberg for you.
A local celebrity in the house tonight. We have Miss Gretchen Wirth. You can find her on the news, HOI 19 News Daybreak from 5 to 7 a.m. If you're like me, you won't see it. You can also check her out at 5 p.m. She hosts Good Company. She also is from Chicago, which is pretty cool. And she's been living here in the Peoria area for 15 years now.
Our next judge is Ms. Val Springborn. Mrs. Springborn was a teacher here at the high school where she taught science for 13 years. She also acted as a student council advisor back when Dragon Spotlight started in 1995 over at West Campus. So she's seen most of it, almost all of it, you know. She is a PCHS alumna and also a U of I grad. During her time at PCHS, she spent a lot of time accompanying the notables, and she has continued her passion for music, becoming a music director at her church. After she retired from teaching, she began her best job as a mom, and she currently lives in, yes. Yeah? On top of handling all of the everyday responsibilities that come with being a mom, she's also highly involved with her community. She helps organize the Marigold Festival every year and helps spearhead different YWCA projects. Currently, she lives in Pekin with her husband and her 11-year-old daughter.
Last but not least, we have Ms. Shayla Hancock in the audience. A Pekin alumni herself, and when she was here, she participated on the speech team, in the plays, and she hosted Dragon Spotlight herself. She now teaches here at Pekin as the drama teacher and the English teacher, and she's directing the musical, which you can all come see in April. In college, she got into comedy, and she was actually the leader of her comedy improv group at the university that she went to. She's psyched about tonight.
Now that we've introduced our marvelous panel of judges, I think it's important to draw us back to our theme for tonight, 20 years and counting. So I think that to really consider the theme, we need to think about all of the achievements in the last 20 years. We saw Steve Jobs' idea of a music sharing online site come to fruition in iTunes. We saw different gadgets that used to be exclusive only to spies like James Bond come to life as smartwatches donned on the wrist of an average Joe. But most importantly, we saw the creation and tailoring of all the talent you guys will see tonight. So,
without further ado, let's bring on our first act. The first act is in the miscellaneous category. It's a video that centers around the concept of passion. It's by Hugh Fan, Alex Fan, and Mallory Ingalls. Bring them on up.
So my name's Mallory Ingalls, this is Hugh Fan and Alex Fan. And so we have a love for making videos, so we were like, hey, let's create a video and show it tonight at Dragon Spotlight.
We made a video tonight. We've made a lot of videos before, but we've never really had to premiere in front of a live audience like this before. So I'm really feeling like a real Hollywood director right now. It's great. But yeah, we got to work with some pretty passionate people on this one.
So we hope this video inspires you all to do what you're passionate about and follow your dreams.
Can't be sure about
empowering act, I would say. I hope that it kind of opened up your minds and encouraged you to kind of pursue the passion with your life that some of those people did. So, Sean, am I correct in saying that our next act is in the vocal category?
Why, yes, I believe it is.
Well, did you know that I have a little bit of a vocal background myself?
How you know?
That's what I was supposed to say. What kind of background you got?
Well, actually, I sing baritone in my church's choir, so I get down low. But pretty much, I honestly just think I'm there to kind of, you know, amplify the hymns and just make things louder. Not because I'm, like, actually good, but just because I can add noise to it.
Okay. Well, let's leave the vocals to someone who knows what they're doing. Next up, we have the great Carrie Whitford singing "To Make You Feel My Love."
Hey!
really hit me right in the feels, you know? It just got me.
Nathaniel, get it together, man.
No. Alright, you're right. I just need to pull myself together before all of this landslides, you know? I just gotta stop it before anything else happens. You know, I just can't do this. I can't embarrass myself in front of all my peers. You know what I mean? So
I get you. Let's bring Addie Mink out with Landslide. Get him off stage.
Of course I do not. Do you?
Well, I don't want to brag, but back in the day, I used to play the violin. I was a child prodigy of sorts.
Oh, I'm sure. Very, very interesting. Do you still play?
No. Let me tell you about the director, okay? Everybody's got earwax, right? We do. Well, he realized he had some in the middle of rehearsal all the time. He'd pick it like this and wipe it on his gut. I was done.
That's pretty gross. So is that just one of the reasons, or is that the only reason why you quit?
Well, it wasn't rock and roll enough for me, you know?
Okay, yeah, I definitely know what you're talking about, for sure. You know, I can appreciate myself some rock and roll, but I'm not exactly an expert on it. So maybe our next act, Damon Haney, can teach us all a little bit about what rock and roll really is.
That's right. Next up, we have Damon Haney. He is performing a instrumental rendition of It's Not Raining, I Think, on his drums. Damon Haney!
Day.
country phase days.
You know, it definitely had me feeling some strong emotions. I don't know what it is about tonight, but just, I'm getting emotional about everything. It was just a very, very powerful performance. So, do you think that we should introduce our next powerful performance of Katie Curtis and Jillian Leeds? Dancing to a song called Never Let Me Go?
You know, as much as I want to bring them out here right now, excuse me, Kevin? Could you raise the house lights? There's some people that are looking for a seat, please. Thank you. I can see you all. Hello. Thanks. Thanks, dude. You're welcome. Now they're taking too long. Alrighty, let's get this show rolling. Jillian Leeds and Katie Curtis, everyone!
Still look the same to me as before I went out.
was fantastic. I really think that I didn't want that performance to ever let me go.
Me too. I wish I could dance like that.
Well, you know, I know a lot of people wish, but I think I actually can. I know a few dance moves myself.
You do you?
Yes, I do.
Get a load of this guy, okay? Let's see him.
Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go get ready real quick during the next performance, and then I'll show you what I'm talking about, okay?
Alright, Nathaniel. Uh-huh. Well, while he goes and gets ready, let's give it up for our next performer in the vocal and instrumental category, Jordan Pruitt, singing Hallelujah!
Music to
Stewart, everybody. Nathaniel.
Okay. I'm here. Yes.
Are you ready?
Well, I think I'm as ready as I'm ever gonna be. Hit it, DJ!
Somebody, I think. Celebrity, maybe?
I think I know exactly who you're talking about. You're talking about the one and only MJ, Michael Jackson?
No, I don't think that's it. I think it's someone different. Someone alive, maybe.
Wow. That kind of narrows it down. So, you must be talking about my kindred spirit, Aloe Black. Because, you know, I'm the man.
No, again. I'm gonna figure this out while our next act performs. It's Cody Salem and Angel Pratt doing a duet of Photograph by Ed Sheeran.
Inside these pages, you just hold me. I won't.
on 6th Street, hearing you whisper through the phone, wait for you to come home.
Of an Ed Sheeran classic. So, back to what we were talking about before, Sean. Did you figure out who I remind you of?
Still stumped.
Well, I think I've got a guess, so let me show you. Is it, Ed Sheeran?
Maybe?
I get it. The hair.
See, yeah, I was trying to, you know, go at it.
It makes sense now. All right, let's bring on our next performer, Halle Brokamp. That's right, Halle Brokamp. Singing Show You.
Streets at night, you're way too short to get on this ride. No, I'm not the trying to tell me that I gotta be home when the street won't slow. You can watch your TV show. I will watch what I wanna watch. No, I won't listen to you. Do what I wanna do and I will. Walk this road ahead, 100 miles on my hands. Do I need to show you? Guess I gotta show you. And if you don't believe me now, I'll flip the whole world upside down. Do I need to show you? Guess I gotta show you. Watch me walk across this wire, tiptoe through the cones of a blazing fire. Watch me fly this sky in the rain. I'll jump rope with my ball and chain. Come by and knock on my house of cards. If it falls on my building from the storm, I won't listen to you. Do what I wanna do and I will walk this road ahead. Don't believe me now, I've lived the whole world. gotta show you, yes, I gotta show you. And if you don't believe me now, I'll flip the whole world upside down. Do I need to show you, yes, I gotta show you.
Hallie Brokamp, everybody! You know, she really showed us. Ah, her talent, right, judges? Just like you showed us how you can dance.
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
You know, I try. But I think that the audience probably deserves to see another group of people who actually know what they're doing when it comes to dancing. So I think that now we should introduce our halftime entertainment for the night, the PCHS Pomps team performing a dance to Work Song by Hozier, as choreographed by senior Ashley Scotty and Lindsay Lucas.
Thank you. you're not us.
You need to have a sense of humor when you're an Adams. You need to have a taste for death. Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Adams, you do what Adams always do. So keep your sunshine and keep your green country music in Tennessee.
Keep your laughter
and MTV and all will be alright.
When you're an Adams,
that's right. When you're an Adams, late nights out with the Adams.
Thank you. control.
Thank you.
pretty sweet.
They really knew how to work on their toes. I mean, more than they were expected to. They were really put on the spot, okay?
They definitely were, and I think that just kind of is a prime example of the great creativity and talent we have here at PCHS. Now, since we had to put them on the spot, I think it's only fair that we put some of our judges on the spot. And possibly ask them to tell us an interesting fact about themselves that I might have missed during their introductions or something else like that. I know, it's on me. I'm bad. So, all right, we're gonna put you guys on the spot, so. Thank you. So we are going to start on this side right here with Miss Springborn. Would you mind telling me anything about yourself? I don't, whatever it is.
Oh boy. Actually, this might not be about myself, but it goes back 20 years ago when we started Dragon Spotlight. And believe it or not, it was in November, and it was down at West Campus. And we were scared. We wanted to put on a talent show that brought out some of our sleeper talents at Pekenheim. We know that we have that in our halls and we have no idea what's out there. So in order to make sure that we had an audience, it was free if you brought a canned food, because it was in November that went along with the Student Council canned food drive. So we are very excited that, look at how it's grown. 20 years later, you guys are awesome, and it never ceases to amaze me what talent we have at Pekin High. So yay for you guys, keep it up. 20 more years of Dragon Spotlight.
Thank you so much. I think that really speaks truth to our school as well, talking about the canned food drive and everything. I would like to say that we are continuing with that altruistic spirit here at the high school. So now I'm going to pass it over to the other side to Miss Sean Foote and have her put them on the spot.
It's good.
Hello there. Do you have any special talents or an anecdote or something?
Is Miss Hudson in the audience tonight? Because I just used a great word.
Well, I don't really have any talents, you know, but I've got a few things I could say. Well, actually, that was quite lovely, Mrs. Springborn. I don't have anything to follow that, except that I'm deathly afraid of balloons. Like, deathly. They're frightening. They pop when you don't want them to, and I don't like it.
That's going to be hard to follow.
Back to you, Nathaniel.
It definitely will be, but I believe that if anybody can do it, it can be our very own Mrs. Stoles. So, would you like to grab the mic and tell us a little something about yourself, or the school, or whatever?
Where are you going?
You were here for the first Dragon Spotlight as well, weren't you? So do you have anything you want to add that she might have missed or anything like that? Are we holding up to your standards as hosts and everything?
You guys are doing a great job.
Thank you.
All right, now we will get back to the rest of our judges later on. But now we're going to introduce our next act, Brock Massalia and Gavin Gray, with their vocal instrumental performance of Yitzhak Jam.
Yeah.
dude. I don't really know where that came from. I just kind of thought in meant like the opposite of out. That's all I thought.
Well, that seems true, but it's also a little vague. So why don't we bring out Alexander Ruddy, Matthew Hoyle, and Ethan Green with their original vocal performance of In. And then maybe I'll understand.
What's up, dude?
Look at this photograph!
Nah, just kidding.
We are going to perform a rap for you today. So, yo, kick that swag tune, yo.
You're just gonna one song, one song.
You're a shooter,
they call me No Fire. They call me G Reaper.
I'm a revenue.
They're gonna find me. First y'all gonna find me. What spotlight to a boy like me? Now he plays remind me. Boss so hard, that's so crazy. On the stage acting Jay-Z, Kanye, born all the way. Remix Parasites all day.
Now, inside, I'll get the high fire. First one to go in, I'll make sure to keep it flowing. I'll keep up with the rest. Even though I'll admit I'm not the best, gotta switch up flow. Once I accomplish it, I'll let it go. Face move me, I'm looming. Can you zoom me? Tell me a true thing. Let me speed it up for a sec. Hope to God I don't wreck. I keep my head high. Don't know whether the passion die. My heart till the day I die. Go fly so high, never till the line. Let that room run dry. I've got my friends here who plan to go in. But like I said, boys, don't let that flow be slowing. Yeah, Lil Fire and Big Red, they all hearing what I say. All right, get ready to go in. Here we go.
Big Red, pass the mic. I'll only be a minute. I haven't prepared, so I'm probably gonna wing it. But when you're as cool as me, it doesn't really matter. When other MCs hear my name, they all scatter. It's because I'm the coolest guy to ever ride.
Bird.
But up with the sweet talk, let me tell you why. I truly am the world's coolest guy. My middle name is cool. Well, actually, it's Steven. But I'll change it when I'm 18, so that's a reason. Another point which, if I may say, every essay written has been made it in the day.
I'm grinding it. Gotta see where you're hiding it. Gotta see where you're residing it. So I can name this song. Gotta show you where my pride is in. My pride is in. Yes, pride is in. I'm ready like I'm fighting it. Been busted like I'm hiding it. I'll admit it, I was quiet then. But now, don't ask how. Just say why. Why so high? Just like you died. These fresh fields I'm trying to plow. These yields I'm trying to pass. These fresh wheels I'm made to last. These speeding guns, we are gonna blast. I keep on doing it day in and day out. I'm playing it, played on display. That all should have me. I'm a roll up, I'm a roll up. Y'all think they hearing what I said? I feel alive. Hit my stride about to go into overdrive. Let's be real. I'm playing with a sailor, making it feel crazy. I'm never gonna stop. Never gonna pop. I was gonna pop and drop. And I stop. And I lock. Time for the drop to make it fly. Get it with a kiddo, let it hit. Get it in. I'm gonna send it with an ass. I'm gonna get it to the one.
What it truly means to be in.
Great. That's great. Well, let's bring Brittany Hill out on stage. She'll be singing a song and then.
Thank you. but I can make an explosion.
This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Do that more song.
I think I speak for all of us when I say that that was a truly incredible performance. It's so great to see such an emotional dedication, and I hope that her brother was able to see that. So, all I can say is that I absolutely loved it.
It was awesome. Speaking of the... Our next performer is Noah Bernard. Yeah. Singing Love. Another throwback tune, but I also think that that act had a lot of originality in it, as he was able to incorporate
the smooth older tracks with some more modern, I don't know if like dabbing's a dance move or like whatever it is, but he was able to incorporate that somehow, so that's pretty original to me.
I didn't know he could sing. Great job, Noah. That was awesome.
It definitely was. Now, I think that up next we have another original act. Am I correct?
Next up, we have Alec Damon on the drums performing an original Newsflood song. It's original. Let's give it up for him.
Thank you.
We're showing you some more smooth dance moves that we got going here, you know? This is how I learned to moonwalk. Learned. Anyway, I believe that our next performance, coming from the act known as the Wooden Tables, also. Drums.
The Wooden Tables have a nice fan group, I can see. A couple of them are coming back to the stage from last year to reclaim that vocal performance win.
That is true. Last year, two of their members, Jake Zercher and Matt Filarski, came up here and they did a performance of a song called Fast Cars. Which, I don't know about you guys, but I had definitely never heard it before. When I looked at my program and I saw Fast Cars, I didn't know if we were gonna prepare for a NASCAR theme song or like what we were gonna get out of it, but they absolutely blew me away, and I am not ashamed to admit that that night I went home and purchased that song on iTunes and jammed out to it for a couple of days. No other work was done. But this year, they are doing a song that I'm actually somewhat familiar with. I believe they're doing Accidentally in Love. And the reason why I know that is because I'm a child at heart, and I definitely fell in love with Shrek 2, and that song is in it. So, yeah, that's the extent of my musical background.
You know, Shrek 1 is, they made it into a Broadway musical. It's on Netflix if you want to check it out. It's good. So, as much as I want to bring them out here right now, I was wondering, Nathaniel, do you keep up with current events at all?
Well, you know, I try. And I'm sure that everybody was coming here tonight to try and get away from, like, the 2016 presidential race, you know, elections, all the politics and everything. But I think that it's very current as far as that goes. And all I'm gonna say is that this is the only time I'm gonna mention it, and I'm not gonna talk about building huge walls or like democratic socialism or anything like that. I'm just gonna drop the mic, drop the topic of politics, and introduce the Wooden Tables.
Hello. I'm Jake. That's Sam on the guitar. Eric on the bass. And of course, Matt on the drums. And we are the Wooden Tables. And this is that one song from Shrek.
Thank you.
in on the end.
They've got two different components to it. So, without further ado, please welcome the PCHS teachers.
Thank you.
I'm just curious, are those like those like skin tight suits? Aren't that, isn't that like breaking the dress code? Kind of. I'm just thinking, can I wear that tomorrow?
Well, I think that we've come to that time where I want to say not only thank you to our teachers for their amazing performance, but thank you to you for being such an amazing audience tonight. And
give yourselves a round of applause.
Our fantastic panel of judges. Don't worry, for those of you who we did not put on a spot, we'll catch you later, okay? But now has been the moment you've all been waiting for. Drum roll, please. I really hope I don't pull a Steve Harvey. And our vocal winner is...
Noel Bernard!
Congratulations, Noah. All right, moving on. The winners for our vocal instrumental category are... Congratulations to them. Yeah! Our next category.
I like that guy.
I don't know if I like him. He keeps interrupting me. I'm just kidding. It's okay. Our next category is the dance category, and it appears that our winners are.
We'll find out after this break.
Spotlight winners.
That's right. Yeah.
Applebee's gift card. Just call your movies by name.
Thank you again for everybody who came out and made the 20th anniversary of Dragon Spotlight one to remember. So thank you again to everybody. Thank you to my co-host, Sean. And thank you to everybody involved in this. Huge shout out to our sound guys, Kevin the Light Guy. Creative Expression to providing the packages for our judges. Without any of them, none of this would have happened. And a big thank you to Miss Call who put this whole night